Alright guys, as you see here, I have my T-Rex trapper and peanut butter. I have my pennies. Alright, it's gonna be my little setup. And as you see, it won't stay open. Okay, there we go. That's rare. Okay. I've caught over 30 mice in, I would say, over a 24-hour period. They're trapped in here, nowhere to go. So they're pretty much running. Let's see. Show you. They're running back and forth from here where the exit was behind the stove, which I packed. It looks rusty back there, but it's just foam. Brillo pad is stuck in there. And they're running back and forth. You should be able to hear them, actually. I hear those little feet just scratching along the inside of that wall behind that board. Come out behind there, run back there. It's extra clean in that part. And I have traps hid everywhere, but it literally smells like bleach and cleaning chemicals. So they run right back into the kitchen. And right now, oh, there's one. I just heard them. Like, they're literally trapped. And it sounds kind of heinous, horrible, but they gotta go. And I'm gonna be the one to do it. Oh my God, look at me fast, boy. That is crazy. But don't worry, we're gonna get this bacterial disease bugs out of here, because I would hate to come here and see a slithery guy just enjoy himself. Oh my God, they're in the stove. I'm about to turn the stove on and run them out of it. This is crazy. You talk about infestation. Holy snaps. These guys are just like acrobatic. All right, so turn the stove on. And I'm gonna set this foam back here as well and let you guys get a chance to see a trap. Now, as that stove began to look at him, there he is, in and out, little guy. Look at the guy. These guys are like super brave, man. Like, they are so comfortable. Like, come on. I know I'm a big guy. And this guy is not afraid at all. That is crazy. All right, let's get back to getting this trap set up. Got your peanut butter right there in the middle. Now, as you can see back in the trap, and it's gotten a little chewed and worn, but it still works. Every now and then it does it, and that's what I use the penny for. And I also coat it with peanut butter, so it tilts the peanut butter up in an angle, about a 90 degree angle. And when they put their feet on the penny, it releases the spring in the back. Boom. All right, guys, I'll be back. Alright guys, gonna leave this phone here. Hopefully they do not take my phone and sell it on the market out here. Cause these guys are crafty. And still haven't tackled the pantry yet, so we have lots to do. I'll be back.
One, two, three. These guys come in abundance, man.